Okay, let's do some math for fun. Today, I have a log triangle for you guys. What do I mean? Well, let me show you. First, let me give you guys a right triangle. And then, of course, because we are talking about log functions, let's talk about the natural log. Let me label this as ln x, and let's say this right here. It's a little bit longer, so let's say ln of 2x. And then, just for fun, let's make this ln of 3x. And the question is it possible for us to find an x value so that this is actually a legitimate right triangle? Of course, the answer is yes, because otherwise, how can we continue, right? And the truth is, it seems like when you have a right triangle, just put down some like functions like you want in a good pattern, sometimes you can actually come up with some really nice questions. But anyway though, as always, please pause the video and try this first. Done? Alright, of course, we will first have to use the Pythagorean theorem because we're talking about the sides of a right triangle. So let's make this right here square, and then we add this side square, which is ln of 2x. Square that, and then make this equal to that square, which is ln of 3x. All right. Now here's a small problem because the input here is x, and then the input here is 2x and 3x. They're all different. Cannot do too much, but don't worry, because this is ln of 2 times x. Thanks to the log property, we can break it apart as ln 2 plus ln x. Likewise, we can do the same thing right here. So let me just keep it as how it is. We have ln x squared, and then for this one, we have ln 2 plus ln x, and then square, and this is equal to ln 3 plus ln x square. Now, much better. And let's just go ahead and multiply out everything and hope for the best. This right here stays, so I'm just going to keep it as ln x square. And for this, of course, we square the first thing, which is going to be just ln x, well, ln 2 square, and then we add 2 times this and that. So we have 2 ln 2 and then ln x. And lastly, we have to add this square, so we have to put this down right here. And then I'm going to put on right hand side right here. This is going to be equal to this square, which is ln 3 square, and then plus 2 times this and that. So we have 2 ln 3 and then ln x. And lastly, this guy square, which is ln x square. Pretty cool. All right, now we can just continue and then just finish this. It looks pretty nice because now we have a quadratic equation in terms of ln x. All right. So now the method just cleans things up. And here's the good thing. We see that on the left-hand side, we have this ln x squared. Likewise, the right-hand side. In fact, we can cancel this and that out. But we still have this ln x squared, right? Let's just deal with it. Ln x and then square. Okay, let me put this and that on one side and then, of course, factor out the ln x. So I'll keep this right here. That will be plus 2 ln 2. And then this to the other side, so it becomes a minus 2 ln 3, and then the ln x right here. And lastly, I'll put this to the other side as well. So we have plus ln 2 square minus ln 3 square, and this is equal to 0. Cool. Now let's see if there's anything that we can do before we continue. For example, right here, we can factor out 2. And then we have ln 2 minus ln 3, right? So we can use the log property to put them together. So all this is just 2 ln of 2 over 3. And this right here actually can be simplified a little bit too, because this is actually the difference of two squares. So we can factor it. So this becomes ln 2 minus ln 3, like so, and then multiply by ln 2 plus ln 3. So in fact, we are using a lot of things that we learned in algebra with this question. All right, and now let's just multiply out. Let's just keep everything right here again. So here we have ln x square, wrong color, ln x square. And then I'm just going to keep this as how it is. So we have the plus 2 ln 2 over 3, and then we have this ln x. And then for this right here, we can combine them as well. So I'm going to say plus, and this is just ln of 2 over 3. And then ln of 2 plus ln 3, we can just multiply the inside. So this is just ln 6. Yeah, so this is the constant term. And then all in all, we have this being equal to 0. Okay, quadratic equation in terms of ln x. Let's use the quadratic formula. All right, this says ln x will be equal to negative b, which is the 2, ln 2 over 3 here. And then, of course, we have the plus or minus. And let's open the square root. Okay, b squared, we have that, which is 2 ln 2 over 3 square minus 4 times a, which is 1. And then c is that, so ln 2 over 3, ln 6. Okay, and then everybody, right, all over, right, 2 times 1, that's the a value. Cool. All right, so let's take a look at the inside, because in fact, we can simplify a little bit, and let's do it right here. So firstly, we can square that, so this is going to be 4, and then this square, I'll just write it as ln 2 over 3, and then square. And then minus 4 times 1 times that, so just minus 4 ln 2 over 3, and then ln 6. And notice both of them have 4, and also the ln of 2 over 3, so let's factor that out. So we will have 4. ln 2 over 3, like so. And then here, we have another, right, ln 2 over 3. And then minus, this right here is ln 6. And this right here is what? Yeah, a log minus another log, so I can just do this divided by that. So let's see, this will become ln of 2 over 3, and then divided by 6, which is the same as ln of 2 over 6 times 3, right, which is 18, and then that's just ln of 1 over 9, and that's just ln of 9 to the negative 1, and put the negative to the front, yeah. So this right here becomes negative ln 9, and then we still have this in the front. Cool. All right, and don't forget that we still have a square root, right? So it looks like, okay, and then, is this really okay? We have a negative inside of the square root. And we are not looking for any complex numbers, because otherwise, we don't have that in real life, unfortunately. We want that to be a legitimate triangle. So, now don't worry. In fact, ln of 2 over 3, because 2 over 3 is less than 1, this is actually negative. Negative times negative is positive. And if you would like, we can put this negative up here and make that into an exponent. So we can rewrite this as square root 4 and then ln 3 over 2 and then ln 9. Yeah. And finally, an icing on cake is that I'm going to write this as 2 square root of ln 3 over 2 ln 9. All right. So now what do we have? I'm going to split the fractions. So we have negative 2 ln 2 over 3 over 2, and then plus or minus. And then all this is just that. I'm just going to write it as 2, and then square root of ln of 3 over 2 ln 9 over 2. Aha, this and that cancel, this and that cancel. And again, let's put a negative right here, and then we can do the reciprocal. Very nice. All right, so now don't forget that we have ln x is equal to all this. So let's see what we will actually end up with. Now here's the deal. If you ignore the triangle and just look at this, ln x is possible to be negative. So it looks like we have two solutions. However, because we are talking about a right triangle, we don't want any sides to end up with a negative value. Therefore, ln x, the whole thing, we don't want it to be negative, so we have to get rid of that. And you can check on your own. This is actually bigger than ln of 3 over 2, so we have to get rid of the negative, all right? And then lastly, we can just do e to this power, e to that power, exponentiate both sides, and we will get this and that cancel, so just x. Well, let me cancel that for you guys. We get x equals. Now let's do two things right here. The first thing is that we are going to separate, this is just e to this power times e to that power. And the second thing is that this and that will cancel. So we have 3 over 2. And then e to that power, unfortunately, they cannot cancel. We'll just write it as e to the square root of ln of 3 over 2 times ln 9. Yeah, that's it. Cool. And if you would like, you can use your calculator and let me know what the answer is. I believe that's 0. I don't remember, but like, you guys can go and try it.
So if you find math interesting, then I think you'll also like Brilliant. Brilliant is one of the best websites for math and science, and I've been a long-term user because of the variety of courses that they have. Currently, they have over 60 interactive courses in math, science, and computer science. These classes are designed to make fun and engaging. I like the logic, algebra, and calculus classes because they often provide me a different point of view so that I can learn something new. And let me tell you, they have beginner level of math courses and also advanced courses such as differential equations and quantum computing. I'm sure you will find something that you like. Plus, if you use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen, then you can enjoy a 20% off of the annual premium subscription. So go ahead and check them out. And thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video.